Hi, today super quick teardown, an instrument from my stock, airliner instrument by the way. So first it was maintained by Caribe Aviation in Miami, Florida in 91. So we have here a PSI oil pressure indicator up to 100 PSI made by Thomas Edison Industries, West Orange, New Jersey. Serial number here for you, weight 0.7 libs, the regular connector. And you can see this kind of instrument is actually welded all around. And to open it, I believe, at the workshop, they need to unscrew this plate and hit with a torch all around to melt some solder, that it will of course ruin the paint, and you will need to repaint the thing after you do the repair and then re-weld it. Quite a weird concept, but it is at least a completely sealed unit against moisture mainly. So to open it, I had to cut all around with a saw. So what do we have in here? Actually it is quite simple. We have, you can see the back connector is soldered to the back piece here. We have a few structural frames. We have one galvanometer movement here in the middle. A plate that is not really a circuit board, it is a terminal plate, with a few resistors, potentiometer here, probably some wire wound potentiometer in this thin plated case, and I know this kind of potentiometers are prone to make thin whiskers inside. Because of the tin plating of the case, I have already seen similar ones with actually a forest of tin whiskers inside. So not the best thing for aircraft instrument. Also you can see it is riveted here to this plate. What do we have else? We have front with front dial, which is plexiglass, with a light diffuser here. The lights that are actually seem to be dual lights, because we have each time four legs, which is quite weird. Here also, and we have the wires here going to the back connector, so it should be possible to power them on, but I believe they are 28 volts lights, and they will glow faintly anyways. And it is all. So I was, as this thing was not in a super nice shape, I was curious to see what was inside. I did decide to cut it open. It makes a display piece at least. You can notice a nice concept of clear plastic needle here that will actually pick up, it seems, some light from the middle of the dial here, and it will be act as the light pipe to light the needle in the front. Quite interesting. Actually, let me try to power it on. So for this purpose, I have my set of handmade generic pins converters to go onto connectors of various sizes in both male and female. So it is still a work in progress. When I need one, I make one. Here you have even one for the Russian instrument, like this. So it is quite handy to have when you play with aircraft instruments, but you need to To make them, you need to salvage all connectors and retrieve the pins inside. So let's connect it. It seems the orange is in the middle and the brown might be actually this one. We will assume orange is positive, but as it is incandescent bulbs anyways, it is not a big deal. So first I will try with 5 volts because I do not want to blow the bulbs, and if it is not enough I will apply 27. We are already lit on with 5 volts, so I cut out my light. Seems it is not totally enough. Seems better like this, so you can see how it is lighting up. So I could also play with a galvanometer, but just to see the needle moving anyways. Okay, here is what it looks like with the cover. Quite even. Light distribution, by the way, quite nice. Okay. Interesting. At least I know the lights are working. For some reason, you can see they did paint the top of the lights in black. Or maybe some mirror paint to keep the most of the light output at the correct level for the light distribution piece here. Okay, and it might do a nice thumbnail for the video. So here we are for this thing. One more opened aircraft instrument for knowledge. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.